So this question comes from a patient who is considering IMRT without SpaceOAR. They have a very experienced radiation oncologist, and the oncologist told them that there's growing concern that with SpaceOAR, when they have extracapsular extension, that he'd recommend not using SpaceOAR because that he finds that the cancer cells can be pushed away from the needed radiation area. Do you agree with this?
Well, thankfully, extracapsular extension posteriorly toward the rectum is not terribly common if patients are screening with PSA regularly. So I don't think it's occurring frequently enough to make any policy out of it. But if a patient on MRI was shown to have clear-cut extracapsular extension posteriorly toward the rectum, then I think it would be a question as to whether SpaceOAR could get between the cancer and push some of the cancer cells further away from the treatment field. Patients who are going to very experienced cancer centers, we know the statistics of rectal burns in people that are going to these centers from pre-SpaceOAR studies. And it's not a really high risk, maybe 1% to 2% risk of a rectal burn at an experienced center without SpaceOAR. It is feasible to do it. I think that in cases where SpaceOAR can be safely used, I would definitely use it, because even though rectal burns are rare, they are really devastating problems that can be lifelong when they occur.
Our next question is in regard to GI conditions, so gastrointestinal conditions. They want to know if there's any studies that looked how patients do who have IBS syndrome, so irritable bowel syndrome, and are also receiving radiation for their prostate. Is there any sort of studies that can talk about the effects?
I don't know about studies, but historically, when patients would undergo old-fashioned pelvic lymph node radiation, there was potential long-term damage to the intestines, which manifests like irritable bowel syndrome. That's like unexpected diarrhea, constipation, stomach discomfort that never goes away. And this, with modern techniques, has been greatly reduced. But there's always consideration of increased risk in people that have bowel problems like Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. And historically, radiation was completely avoided when people had those pre-existing problems. Now, with modern techniques, it is possible to consider radiation, and it comes on an individual basis. How serious is the problem? How big is the radiation field? In the old days, you would never even consider radiation in these individuals, but radiation has gotten so much better that it's now on the table for discussion in select cases.
So on our next question, this person would like an overview of strictures. And then also, once we go over the overview, are there urodynamic testing? Is there treatments for this? You know, so first of all, I guess we should start off with what are strictures?
So people that have treatment of their prostate, most are aware that there's a tube that passes from the bladder through the prostate and out the penis. And that tube is in ground zero, for example, if you have radiation, or if someone has their prostate removed, they slice both ends of the tube at each end of the prostate, and then they sew it back together again. Anytime you have scar tissue created by an incision or by radiation, there is a possibility for excess scar tissue. Think of keloid formation. Some people have seen the large bumps on people's skin after surgery. That's excess scar formation. And scar is very difficult to handle. You try and cut it out, and more scar comes back. This becomes a real issue if it starts to block off the urethra. And there's no simple solution for this. Probably someday they'll invent some sort of a medicine that shuts down the scarring process, but we haven't invented that yet. And until then, now it's just managed. People put a catheter in and wait, and they'll go in and try and gently incise and remove a little of the scar tissue with a knife, hoping it doesn't make it worse. But this is one of the dreaded complications of both surgery and radiation, and 3 or 4% of people that have radical prostatectomy develop strictures. Maybe 1 to 2% of people that have radiation can develop strictures in their urethra. And there's no easy solution. There are some specialists at large clinics that devote their lives to surgical correction of removing the scar and trying to put it back together again, sometimes with success, but it's a really difficult situation that you don't want to get into if you can avoid it.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five, high-five, Can you high five me?
Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks that's awesome.
Also, don't forget to visit our website, pcri.org.